and with a little bit of delay on my computer, we're finally ready to start the next exciting podcast. I'm your host, KRX, and with me in the booth tonight is Windcharger 8199 and special guest, Fallen215. Hey, guys.
Oh, hello.
What is good?
All right, so we don't have a whole lot to talk about today, but I'm sure we can fill that hour perfectly as I drink from my mech cup. Mm-hmm. It literally says mech on it. All right. Unfortunately, I don't have an image ready today because ForzaMotorsport.net decided to act up. It was going to be one of the photos taken from the event at Spa. So
when does ForzaMotorsport.net or ForzaMotorsport.net never act up?
You can tell by my silence. I'm not sure on the answer. Good lordy. All right, so if you guys look at the, well, for the viewers at home, if you're watching the ticker, we now have 14 people in the 2016 season, with Mitch in last place with 8 points.
Did he only run like one or two races or something? Like, did he lag
out?
He
only raced Yas Marina, that's it.
Oh.
So, if he doesn't participate in anything else, then he will hold the record for only entering one race. So, as the season has gone, a Colonel now leads with Fallen in second, Big Ben has moved into third, and Zeta has dropped to fourth. As for the points from last night, we have a Colonel with 84 points. Ben second with 78 points, Fallen gets third with 76, a tie for fourth between Invader Zim and HCR Marco with 60 points, Call Me Darkseid finished with 50 points, more on that after this, Zeta finished behind him with 34, Dirt Viper finished with 32, Dark then Psycho Phoenix. Phoenix got 40, then it was Zeta with 34, Viper with 32, and then in last is Mitch with 8 points. Now, before we go into the reason why Darkseid has 50 instead of 52 points, what did you think of the rolling start situation, Fallen?
I think it's a good idea. The rolling starts is good because, like, let's say you driving like without traction control, you have better control on the starting line instead of with a standing start.
And also less prone to making an accident on the first turn, which surprisingly impressed me at Spa. No one caused a big wreck.
Yeah. Now there's one thing that I have questions about the rolling start. Does that get rid of the whole manual with clutch stalling?
Yes.
Yes.
Good. Good. I was wondering about that because I was thinking about using it for V8.
Personally, I think it's a welcome addition to multiplayer because there are a lot of cars that have the stalling with the clutch. So.
Yeah, V8 supercars, any race car in particular. Now, I heard something said that you can now do tire and fuel wear with cosmetic damage?
Yes, sir.
Yep.
Oh.
I think I'll let you talk about that one as Windcharger has an orgasm.
No need, no need to explain to me. I mean, it everything for my V8 series is coming together. I mean, with more tracks, the content update, and all that stuff.
And don't forget,
now we can do pit stops at Daytona.
Yes, we know.
Which will be fun racing in the pack because you're gonna have to go. People gonna be going, I'm pitting this time, like waving their hand out the. Well, now the right side window going. Because V8's a right-hand drive.
Yes, since you mentioned about the new feature that came with the NASCAR pack, which is available as a free upgrade, the quick stops. This not only allows you to set a limit of how many times the drivers have to pit for an endurance race, it will highlight where the entrance to pit road is. Also, it will notify you if people are coming out of pit road or if they're entering pit road. And if you come out of pit road, it will let you know when traffic is coming so you don't hit anybody.
Yeah. Oh, excuse me. Sorry about that.
So I, for one, welcome the quick stop option, but I know for some races it won't be necessary.
Yeah. I just don't like how it covers the whole entire screen and you can't, like, really see anything ahead of you until it's gone.
At least it doesn't wait until you're in control of your car to go away. I've actually seen it, and it gives you a little bit of time to go, all right, now take control of my car now, after it completely disappears.
Yeah.
I don't like that either. I think it was really oversight on Turn 10's part. But then again, you don't really have control over what they change on pit stops anyway. So
yeah, true.
If it was something like the NASCAR games where you could go make adjustments and then it go away as soon as you make your pit stop, I can understand it covering the whole screen. But.
What was it? Oh yes, the other fun feature, which is very helpful for people when they can't see, depending on their point of view, are the little indicators of where cars are on the track. So there's less saying where you are, and more of, okay, there's a car coming up on my left, let me give them space. There's a car in front of me, a car behind me, there you go.
Yeah, and the fact that it changes colors depending on how close they are.
Yep, so it'll turn a bright orange if they're really close, and if they start pulling away, it'll start turning to a clear color until they're completely gone, and then the arrow disappears.
Yeah.
Which is very good for,
Go ahead, Vaughn.
It's very good for, if you're driving cockpit, so you know where people are.
Yeah. And also, I think it is available for when you're, like, on the roof or the bumper, too.
Yeah, it's on all the views.
Mm-hmm. Now, unfortunately, I'm sorry, my chair's a little loud. Quick stops are only available for lap races. You can't do it for endurance races.
Well, timed races. I mean, you can still make an endurance race lap.
You could.
Like, for my Bathurst 1000, it's literally going to be four stints of 40, 40, 40, and 41, or 41, 40, 40, and 40.
Mm-hmm. And but, yeah. I don't know if this was also added, but for lapped races, for those, if you get lapped, it will notify you how many laps down each car is. So I don't know.
Oh.
Yeah, I did a test of that at Silverstone National, and I let the faster cars lap me, and I noticed that I was going a lap down instead of saying how many feet behind it was. And then when you get
changeable?
What's that?
Is that changeable to where you can put it back to feet?
It will unfortunately change back until you get unlapped.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So it's not either or.
Right. And those are the only features that Fallen and I have been able to find, unless there's something else on the list I did not mention.
Yeah. I mean, all the updates, everything that came with the NASCAR pack, they're completely welcome. It just, if they would add a storefront and gifting.
Right. Can't even give replays.
And unfortunately, since Quick Stop covers the entire HUD and shows a spotter's guide when you go into pit, too bad they still don't have animation where you can actually watch the pit crew work on your car. That'd be great for spectate mode, by the way.
Yeah.
There isn't any pit crew yet.
Come on, Gran Turismo 6 had pit crew.
Gran Turismo 4 has a pit crew. That's PS2, man.
Alright, you know where I was? I was on PS3. That's where I was.
In 2004?
Yes. I had the PS3 before all of you. I got special access. It was like a giant CRT monitor. That's what the PS3 was going to be. And it had like the shark fin controllers. Anyways.
Okay, so next up on the agenda, the June events for our car club. And Windcharger, there's one in particular that you want to see.
Yes. It's going to be up to a vote. Now, I think there's two of those little open-wheel cars, the Formula Mazda and the Formula Ford. I don't know how balanced they are. Again, I don't have Forza 6 or an Xbox One, or I would be testing this right now. But the other one is the Ram Runner. And kind of do something like Robbie Gordon's Stadium Super Trucks. You got to have Long Beach because I actually go there. And then a couple other tracks. And I think maybe a competition caution at halfway like they actually do. Which would be, I think that would be funny as heck. But but I say leave it up for a vote for everybody and see which one they want to do. And then do commentary with it.
Now, for the open-wheeled one that you're recommending, Fallen did say that one of the cars is DLC. Correct?
Yeah, the Mazda.
Which one? That's the Mazda.
Okay, the Formula Mazda.
Okay, now, the Formula Ford, then we won't do the Formula Mazda. Because if it's DLC, again, who knows who has all the DLC?
The Mazda is so much better.
I do want to point out, though, we did have one or two events this year that did have DLC cars, and I didn't have them, but I allowed it because chances are nobody was going to actually pick the DLC cars. So... Mm. If we can...
Well, I think...
Sorry, go ahead.
Go ahead.
No, I was just going to say we could leave it up to a vote if people want to do with a Formula Mazda and a Formula Ford, you know, whoever has the pack.
Yeah, how balanced are they compared to
each other? To be honest, I think the Formula Mazda is a lot better because it handles a lot better.
So it would. You think it would run away from the Ford?
Yeah.
Then let's just do the Formula Ford then, because that was the original idea, and then I saw the Formula Mazda, and it was an afterthought, so.
Understood.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, Formula Ford was going to be a V8 supercar support series. I have decided to run it as an IDFRS series, one night series, because running three different series on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, or... Tuesday and Wednesday, or Monday night and Tuesdays when there's no tourneys, and it wasn't going to work.
Unfortunately, Mondays seem to be the only time most of us can actually get together and race.
Yeah.
Speaking of, the originator of the Asia Cup tournament forgot that his tournament was yesterday.
Shib, you suck.
And we hit the Nürburgring full.
Yeah.
In the rain.
Speaking of Nürburgring full, for those of you who watched the highlight, my voice wasn't playing or broadcasting. And I had even clicked the button to say, yes, broadcast my voice. So I'm going to tell you all what I said. Somebody said something about Turn 10 not paying attention and being stupid. I'm like, yeah, they're like those big stupid KV1 and KV1S drivers who sit in front of a TOG and fire their one shot, wait 10-15 seconds to reload while the TOG eats them alive. And then that's when HCR America said, oh, you just made my night with that World of Tanks reference. And then to add insult to injury later on, second clip, I actually had my mic muted the whole time. And Zeta at one point said, it's like a party back here. And I said, not knowing my mic was muted, is there a TOG present? Because TOG is party tank.
Yes,
and then I realized my mic was muted and went, my mic's muted the whole time!
Almost as bad as my Kinect randomly hearing my voice thinking I say Xbox, and then during the fun happy hour with stock cars at Daytona, it automatically kicks in, and then Fallen loses his draft. It's like the one time there wouldn't be a massive wreck to Daytona, and there goes the Kinect. Thank you, Kinect.
Woo!
Yes, sir. It was a grand old time.
But going back to the whole too serious thing. I say leave it up to a vote, and then whichever one is picked is whichever one we run. I'll create two separate schedules for them because I've got the track list in front of me. And I'll look at their websites and see where they run.
Which one was the other one besides
the Ram Runners?
Ram Runners?
Yep.
Just the Rams, right?
Off-road trucks. Yeah, just the Ram truck.
Runner. Oh, okay.
Nope.
And
nope. It's both of these are single make series.
Now, okay, cool.
Sorry.
I think I probably would prefer the Ram Runner.
Well, if we do Ram Runners, how the heck are we going to do commentary?
What do you mean?
Like, will the host who's streaming have to not race and spectate?
I don't get it.
We do for Evo STI.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so a pre-recorded series. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Which means no live streaming for this one.
Which means
it would be great, though, if we could... There's one thing I wish we could do with the Ram Runners. Put the jumps in there that the actual stadium super trucks use. But we can't.
Because turn 10.
Yeah. I wish they'd make a stadium super truck game. I think that'd be fun as heck.
Hey, turn 10. When modern DTM.
Yes. Yes. Oh my god, yes.
We have NASCAR. Where's DTM?
The DTM expansion pack.
Here's the thing, if they do that, well, they already have, no, they don't have Hockenheim. Oh, wait, yeah, they do.
They do.
Yeah. I'm looking at a different track list that's not complete, but, I think maybe. I hope they put Ultra Slaven in there if they do a DTM expansion. Or maybe the Red Bull Ring Spielberg or something. I don't know. They'll put something in there with DTM. Probably another German track that they run at.
Actually,
the Lausch Race or something. Yeah. Ultra Slaven's great track. Love that track. It turn one is very hard. Because I remember watching a video of some racing series there. They go down to the first turn, and half the field crashes, and the guy goes, whoever designed the first quarter needs to be taken to a dark room and beaten.
It is a nasty turn. I've raced it in Project Cars.
I've run it in Need for Speed Shift 2. Unleashed.
What track is that?
I've actually mastered it. Motorsports Arena Ultra Slaven.
I don't think I ever raced in that one.
It's fun. But I mean, we pretty much have the old tracks that the DTM used to run on. DTM used to run at Catalunya. We have Catalunya. We have Spa. We have Hockenheim, Nürburgring. Where else? Brands Hatch they used to race at. So... Yeah, it had to be either the Rebel Ring or Ostroslaven, or maybe even, there's one track in Russia. It's not Sochi. It's another one. Moscow Raceway that they run on. Boy, that one's got a lot of layouts. I'd like to see that one on a video game.
Well, if they can get the rights for it, I wouldn't see it as a problem.
Yeah, I mean, they can probably get the rights for a Sochi track, but I would still like to see Moscow race because the DTM does race there. Same thing with the WTCC. We've only got one WTCC car, the Honda. Where's the Cruze? Where's the Citroen? Where's the Lada? And now, where's the Volvo?
Nobody knows.
Because Volvo's in their first season in the series. And Citroen, I believe, finally got nerfed. So, yay!
So is the Avensis not is a different series? Event the Toyota Avensis? Is that a different series from the Civic?
Yeah, it's British touring cars.
Oh, okay.
The Civics, the FIA World Touring Car Championship. All the other ones, the Aventus, the BMW, the other touring car, front wheel drive touring cars, the Mercedes, they are.
There's a Mercedes, an Audi.
Yeah, those are MSA Dunlop British touring cars. They're not FIA.
I am still here. Don't worry. I didn't die. Yet.
But, yeah, those are...
Well, I guess there's something else we can talk about real quick, and it's actually going to lead into another discussion. Okay, so... There was a few complaints about Call Me Darkseid corner cutting during two races, but we have footage from one of them, which was at Yas Marina. And I'm actually going to show the footage that was recorded from Darkseid's point of view. There are four instances. Now, have the two of you watched the footage?
I can't watch the footage, so I have to wait until I watch the stream later.
Alright, shoot, can't watch it on YouTube. Darn. All right, let me go get the footage. I'll be right back.
But, no, to the people at home, while he goes and gets the footage, there, the first race, it was running wide to get better entry into the turn. But I said it's an actual legit tactic that they use in the real world, as long as he's only doing two wheels over. So, I go by a two-wheel rule. If you put four over, then it's cutting to me, or definitely gaining too much of an advantage. But...
Alright, so I have the footage, and I'm going to switch my black screen to the computer. There we go. Alright, now Fallen was able to watch the replays and provide commentary, so I'm going to play it right now, starting with the first instance. So Fallen, if you want to provide some playback on what happened.
You want me to look up the replay right now?
If you want. I got it playing right now. I can keep playing it. But from the first instance, trying to get past Big Ben, he did cut on all fours, and he does it again on lap, I believe, three, a second time, same area.
Yeah, and I remember hearing Ben go, "Wow, what a cut!"
Yeah,
and then he goes, "That's not a cut. It's just taking a shorter route." And Ben goes, "That's what's called cutting." So,
and of course, again on lap three, a different area, he cuts another S, and he does it again on the last lap, second area, and cuts through the S's three times. Just this way, he's up with Ben. Alright.
By my standards, he would have already had a 10-second penalty.
And unfortunately, corner cutting is something we've not brought up in the rule book for our car club because, again, the gentleman's agreement that you know how to drive and we don't have to worry about watching and saving replays to see if you actually are legal to try and.
Yeah. I mean, there are rare instances where people will go, "I don't think that's legit." But again, they're rare.
Now, someone's probably going to say, "Well, the person who was live streaming corner-cutted, the person who was live streaming was trying not to get the other drivers."
Mm-hmm. There's a difference. If you cut and gain, and you're intentionally cutting to gain, then it's a penalty. If you're cutting to avoid a contact or collision, and you don't gain anything, it's fine.
it's like watching the replay. Dark Side does not have anybody around him to warrant, you know, a cut. But here he is, he's cutting these particular areas here.
Yeah, it was a clear cut.
And we did watch the replay from Bathurst, and there's only one area which I see that everybody cuts, and that's when you go up the hill, and then
the, you said Bathurst Spa.
Thank you. There's that one area at Spa when you go up the hill. Yes. And everybody cuts it. I've never seen a problem with it because most cars can take that turn flat out.
If everybody does it, I don't see pinging it for one person. But if it, but if everybody does it, if like I can understand first lap because there's going to be people side by side.
Oh yes.
I mean, if you're side by side and you do it to avoid it, but if you're by yourself and you cut that, there's no excuse for you not to get pinged.
So, instead of being super severe and cutting him another position, we decide we're going to do a 2-point penalty for that.
Because it'd be the same anyway.
Yeah. So that makes us wonder, should we put it in the rule book now that if you're intentionally corner cutting to gain an advantage and there's no one around you?
I think what it is you get a warning, and then every time you get caught cutting, you get a 5-second penalty.
Okay. So, it's something that we will have to consider and make sure that's in effect because that really wasn't called for, personally.
Yeah.
And I know this whole thing, people will go, well, these are just for fun. Well, yeah, but just because it's for fun doesn't mean you stick your head up your butt and run like an idiot. Or just because it's fun doesn't mean you can get away with everything.
Yeah.
I mean, you still got a driving standard that, as online racers, that is pretty much equivalent to what actual race car drivers use.
And it's like when Zim rammed me a few times, throughout some races, I could have penalized him for it, but I didn't because some cars have really crappy braking. Like the Mazda RX-7. You have to literally smash the brake button in order to stop.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah.
Anyways. Well, that was a lot to cover in about 31 minutes. Alright, so... Take it away, you two. I've got a lot of stuff to talk about.
Yeah, I don't know what to talk about.
You could talk about your struggle with trying to get back into the lead for the 2016 season.
Oh, yeah. I just got to start racing a lot better, more serious. I just got to take this a little bit more seriously. The last few tournaments, I felt like I was clowning around a bit too much, and I messed up. And I think... I gotta build my cars over, like, more power. Because the last few tourneys, I've been just building them for handling. I think that's been killing me.
Okay. Duh. Because every time you build power, you kill us all.
Yeah, I just can't... I haven't adjusted to Forza 6 yet. Like, the how to build a car in power yet. So I gotta mess around with it.
Yeah, and
what was that?
I think that was a Pontiac GTO 69. Now, there's one that goes around and it's so loud.
Sounded like that farm truck that killed that Huracan off the line. For those of you who have not seen that, go look that up on YouTube. Farm truck destroys Huracan or Lamborghini Huracan. I mean, it wasn't all motor. Granted, he had nitrous. He purged it on the line, but that truck squatted and went. And the Lamborghini goes.
That sounds like a euphemism for somebody trying to go take a crap on the toilet. Thank you for the mental imagery. My face when I'm looking at my pizza. My face when you're telling me this. My face.
Well, alright, I'll put it this way. It dragged the back bumper pretty much all the way down the track.
Thank you.
It didn't do a wheelie. It came close to putting that back bumper on the ground. It just went... No delay, nothing. Gone.
Nice. Well, I was going to say, phone, word of advice, yes, take it serious, but don't take it too serious that you're going to rage quit.
Yeah, not like that.
Yeah, don't be that guy.
Yeah.
Unless you get spun around a few hundred times in the Chevy Cobalt Cup, and then you go Super Saiyan, and then you try to race.
Yeah.
We're never going to let that go.
Unleash the inner beast.
I got so mad in that tournament. I was doing good at Silverstone, and then my parents had to interrupt everything and make me take up the dog. I'm like, are you kidding me? Can you go away? I was catching Zeta. Everything. Silverstone. On 4.
You can totally watch the footage of that on my YouTube channel. Just look for the Chevy Cobalt Cup 2014.
And then I got spun out at Sedona, which was another good track for me.
Yes.
God dang it, my game froze.
That was between you and...
Broom.
Yeah, Broomski.
I got dumped by Broom, which is uncharacteristic of him. He usually never does that.
And it was like the first lap.
First lap, turn one. There goes Windcharger. He's in the gravel trap. He's done. Yep. And I was like, what the hell?
And we have multiple angles of it, too.
Yeah.
But also at the same time, there were at least one or two cars that slowed down. Because that gravel trap is nasty in 4.
Yeah.
It will force your car to come to a stop.
Oh, yeah. I've seen people come to stop and just go, bam! Let's see. Ladera Evo STI. Which gave Roll Tide the first win for... Well, yeah. He gave Warpath Motorsports his first... Our first IDFRS win.
I think
in Evo STI. Because it was... Wasn't it Erebus and Bandit leading?
No, it was... You're half right about it. It was Erebus and Fallen 215. I think it was Fallen, went over the rumble, slowed, and then when he tried to get back onto the track from, I think, a spin-out, and Erebus made contact.
Sticky pavement.
Sticky pavement.
It crushes dream.
Yep.
But it's okay. Yep, good. Erebus rolled his STI at Sebring.
Oh, what was it? It was the TCR 4 Hours of Lemons at Road Atlanta, where he just kept rolling his car. I think at one point he was just showing off. It's like, hey, I can roll it here. Bloop, over he goes.
I don't think I was watching it at the time. Was that when they had the Toro bus?
Yes, the Toro party bus, which was a pain in the butt to pass, and so was I, but... Simon and Adrian weren't paying attention to me. They were paying attention to the party bus. Which I literally held off one guy for the entire 4 hours. Because I soloed that race.
That's okay, because...
And I think that's what... Yeah, I think that right there was what gave me my love of Road Atlanta. Was that race. And made me so good there, because I literally spent 4 straight hours in my car. It was a 99 Civic on that track.
No rest.
IDFRS for the wicked. You are not yawning on the podcast. As I'm eating a pizza on the podcast.
What kind?
Pepperoni.
Bat dad.
Oh.
You didn't wash your hands.
Oh. And by the way. This podcast is brought to you by chips.
Really?
Congratulations, Peter, you've started a joke.
Yeah, I got a meme all to me now.
Colonel actually ate chips during the stream.
You should have seen my face, but I'm like, it's been so long since I've heard it, I'm not even going to say anything. And then Will was eating them after the fact. I knew it was a stupid question to ask about what kind, but I knew they'd be Fritos.
Fritos, honey barbecue chips, really?
Really? But I told him, I said, when I make his V8 scheme for him, I'm going to put a Frito logo on there, on the quarter panel.
He'd probably like that. Make sure you include Doritos and Nestle Crunch and all those other fun things that was on his Lotus of Spirit.
Well, not Colonel. Will. When I make Will's V8 scheme, I'm going to put a Frito logo on it.
Fritos, yeah.
But no.
I was gonna say, are you gonna have Slim Jim in this?
Snapper to Slim Jim!
Yeah. Oh yeah! Slim Jim to Slim Jim! Yeah! Come get some!
You know, the day I heard that.
Having an aneurysm.
The day I heard that that guy passed away, I was at work. I was working at the gas station. And they told me about it, I was like. And the whole story behind it, because I never heard it.
Yeah.
And I was like, I walked out from behind the counter, grabbed me a Slim Jim, rang it up, paid for it, and ate it.
And out of respect. Macho Man Randy Savage.
Yeah, even though I never watched wrestling.
Neither did I. I just knew him for his Slim Jim commercials growing up.
Looks like I'm the only one that did in here right now.
I'm just going to sit here and eat the crust of my pizza.
I do that too when I eat a biscuit. Because sometimes when my grandma fixes biscuits, she kind of has like a little smaller one of the remaining dough. I could pick the whole thing up, stick the whole thing in my mouth, and I'll go, how? Like the one anime. How?
Wait, Fallen. Wasn't there something that you said at, I think it was Watkins Glen? Something about biscuits?
What?
I don't know. You were talking in one of your voices, and something about biscuits and griddles.
I think that might have been like the last thing.
Okay. Because I was gonna say I want you to do that voice.
I forgot what I said. I said something. I think. How was it? I think Colonel was complaining about something like his speakers. And then I was like, oh man, they forgot to put the gravy on my biscuits.
Yes, that was it.
My dang.
The best thing to happen to our live streams, now allowing Colonel to talk. Come back to us, Wind Charger. Then you can be part of the
I'm fun. Still here. I'm like still. I'm here. I'm here in the. I'm in the parties now. I'm just not in the races. Which, oh my god, that kills me. I'm not in the races because the longer and longer I go without racing, the rustier I get. It's like Battlefield. I tried playing Battlefield one time when I still had my 360. First game, I went 17-12 and was MVP. I carried my team and was still crap. So, and then the next time I did not do good. I was like, oh my god, I am rusty as all hell.
That's perfectly fine. The amount of times that I don't get to play Forza shows, and it's kind of sad.
Well, I mean, I'm one of those people. I'm on Xbox. If I had an Xbox One, I'd be on it all the time.
Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, I'm not. On
only problem
Xbox
is I have a stupid plant where I could put a TV in my Xbox because there's no other room to put this plant. I'm like, come on, get it out of my room, because they forget to water it. I've had to water it twice because it droops.
That's probably why they keep it with you, because you're the only one who actually will water it.
Well, no, they just forget. I told them, I said, take it out of my room because it's being forgotten. And I'll forget to water it until it droops and its tips of its leaves touch the top of the dresser.
Do you want us to Facebook message you every day and make sure you water the plant?
No. No, okay. No, it doesn't that often.
Well, I'm glad we don't have to get to that level of reminder.
Yeah.
Speaking of, if Shib hosts another event, we are going to spam his Facebook every day until that tournament starts. You have a tournament on this day at this time.
Yeah. I have an excuse to miss mine. I don't have the system and game.
Or
I have a legitimate excuse.
You could be like Devin, and you want to do a drift tournament, and we set up the drift tournament, and then your ass doesn't show up because my name's Devin. I forgot to do a tournament.
I think he mainly forgot because he had company over, and then he probably forgot completely.
Because there wasn't a Devin in there, so he couldn't miss Devin.
Okay, Devin, we ain't drifting, man.
Well, speaking of
let's
drift tournaments.
Let's go drifting.
What's up?
Speaking of
I'm
drift
not going to even join.
Major League Gaming now has a Forza 6 1v1 series.
I saw that.
It's basically 1v1 drifting.
I'm surprised that it's actually getting sponsored. I guess drifting is serious business.
Well, when you look at people like on Forza Showrooms Facebook group, yeah, they'll show off their paint schemes, but they won't show off any epic passes in racing. They'll just show off them drifting stupid cars like the Gurkha or the limo. I've seen one of them drift the limo backwards.
And then people... Wait, is this the one that they did at Lime Rack and people are like, oh my god, this is real?
I don't think so.
Okay.
I tried posting pictures of my stuff in that Facebook group, but they kept removing it because it wasn't off of ForzaMotorsports.net. It was off of my phone.
That's pretty anal.
So I threw a massive hit and left. So,
I'm pretty sure that's why you said.
Oh well, they're lost.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well,
I was gonna post a lot of my stuff in there, but nope. Their rule is it has to be off of ForzaMotorsports.net, not any other means.
Well, it's a good thing that people forget about half the stuff they post on Facebook, so you can probably get rid of it within a week, and nobody will remember. You're there for your
no, because I've already left the group.
Just saying, bro. Just saying, bro. I'm gonna eat another piece of pizza. I'm acting very professional right now. I'm eating my dinner while we're podcasting.
Damn, man. You gotta do what you gotta do. You gotta eat, man. Gotta have some food. Sometime, man.
As long as we don't eat anything loud and crunchy, and then we're slurping with our mics on, I think we're okay.
Yeah.
Okay, stop.
The hell?
Heavy breathing.
No, Darth Vader.
Are you okay, man? I'm perfectly fine.
I got this big loogie in my nose I gotta take care of.
You have a push to talk button. Why are you holding the button down while you're coughing and sneezing all over your game controller? That is very disgusting.
YOLO.
This sounds like something from DBZ Abridged.
Oh, that was perfect. Yes. The dough is inadequate, so I will absorb it into my system. I think this was the last person who tried to bribe me. Too bad I don't take money.
Oh.
I'm your biggest fan.
Man, that is some serious power getting thrown around right now.
Damn. We shouldn't sit here and act like a bunch of cowards. We should do something. And do what? Get ragdolled again? No, thank you. Of course you'd say no.
Hey, you actually got a point. I mean, between the Super Saiyans, the Super Namekians, the androids, and whatever the heck Cell is.
Oh, not you too.
Hey, I was on Namek, okay? Shit got crazy. I got stabbed. And blown up.
I've been stabbed and blown up too, and dumped by the only girlfriend I ever had.
Same. But you want to know the difference? When mine left, she took all my money. When yours left, she took all her money.
We have 10 minutes left in the broadcast, and we've completely run out of things to talk about. We're just quoting DBZ Abridged. But yes, we have 12 minutes left to talk. Not about togs, just to talk.
Tog. I had
tog.
I'm dying, bro. I'm dying. Charger, you need to do a mockumentary for National Geographic about the tog in World War II. Why don't you do that?
For that you need to watch The Mighty Jingles. That's where I get all my material from on the tog.
Start right now.
Yeah. Anyway. Don't I really have anything to rant about this week? Except the only thing I am not happy about this week is... excuse me. I apologize. I hate the fact that Logano won the All-Star race. If NASCAR would have kept the final segment of the All-Star to 10 laps, Larson would have won it. It should have been 50-50-10. The format was great. So was the showdown format. But I think they really messed it up having a 13-lap final segment. And then the officiating between segments when it was crap. Even Tony Stewart says it. It's like an online league race.
Oh, speaking of Wind Charger, how's your NASCAR Fantasy League coming along?
I had to think for a second.
It's
going good. I've fallen a little bit behind with getting points done, but with everything going on recently, it's just been hard for me to get the motivation to do it. But usually I'll wait a couple races, do races. Really. I still have to make a ruling on the Talladega Xfinity finish. I don't think Elliott Sadler won it. I think Brandon Poole won it. I'm going to make somebody mad either way. Because one guy had Sadler, Allgaier, and Poole 1, 2, 3 in that order. And he would basically win the race if I go with what NASCAR said. If I go with what I say, which is going to cross the line, he's going to have first, second, fifth. And so, I don't know. It's a tough decision to make, and I still have to make it. But, no, gaming news, I do have some stuff. American Truck Simulator, Arizona's, I think in the closed beta stages, I think the community contributors for ATS and ETS are getting closed beta access.
I am still not held same thing. In Arizona.
Games got built-in GPS. I won't be
I'm still not
lost.
Accountable if you get lost in Arizona.
But
Just like Will's not accountable if I get lost in California.
I've only been to Daigo-san.
I've been to Daigo-san and San Bernardino. I've been to Fontana.
Yeah, but that's not in the game, unfortunately.
Yeah.
But anyway, and also what they're releasing for both American Truck Simulator and European Truck Simulator, advanced coupling, which basically you have to get the kingpin on the trailer to follow the groove on the fifth wheel and lock in like that. Problem is truck mods, they do not like advanced coupling. They'll work with standard, and advanced coupling will be off by default, which is nice. It's an option you have to enable. I'm going to enable it because I don't do anything but the standard trucks. But yeah, that's going to be fun. And then I got 3 games for $15, and they're nostalgic games. Railroad Tycoon 2 Platinum Edition, Railroad Tycoon 3, and Sid Meier's Railroads. I don't really like Railroad Tycoon 3 because the camera angles are garbage. I mean, they're complete trash. So are the controls. Other than that, it's the same Railroad Tycoon as 2 was. Railroad Tycoon 2 Platinum Edition is probably the best one out of them because I know how it operates and I know the cheat codes. Yeah, I still remember those cheat codes back when I had my old IBM laptop that I played it on.
And kiss these days will never know the joy of an IBM. Ever. Yeah. I'm going to sit here and finish my pizza.
My sister told me I was a millennial. I'm like, ah! I laughed. I literally laughed in her face. I don't associate with millennials. I see. Anyway. Enough about politics. Because that's a political subject. We don't want to talk about that.
We are talking about cars. And vehicles.
Yes.
And
yes.
More vehicles. And Wind Charger ranting about vehicles.
Now Dirt Rally is extremely hard.
Fallen, explain to us about the joys of Dirt Rally. Here's something for you could talk about for the next 5 minutes.
My god. Yeah, just to get, like, the AI is extremely hard once you get to, like, past Clubman. Like, if you get to Elite, you gotta really, like, move fast. And it's really hard because, like, if you try to go all out, you risk the chance of messing up your car. But there's some people that can, like, hop over hop over jumps like real fast. It's a game that's better played with a wheel. You have like a disadvantage when you have a controller, but it's fun. The only way I see playing the game with a controller on Rally is the front, like the front hood. I mean, yeah, the front hood cam. Or, like, first-person view. The third person is, like, not good at all.
I remember you were talking in party chat about your car being completely obliterated at one point.
Oh, yeah. My car was absolutely destroyed. The hood was, like, almost completely gone. The front end of my car was, like, almost destroyed. It was the beginning of the race. It was already smoking. And I had like another 10 miles to go.
What track were you doing?
I was doing Finland. And it was a 16,000 mile. No, 16. No, I'm, whoa. Not
16,000 miles. Okay.
It was a 16,000 meter long track, which is like almost like 10 and a half miles. So I had to do that in. With my radiator smoking and the engine light on.
Doesn't get any more serious than dirt.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
And in that game, you can mess up your tire so bad that you'll be driving on the rim.
Reminds me of the days when you tried playing Grid 1, and the harder you took the turn, the more likely your tire or part of your axle would come loose and actually fall off the car.
Yeah.
Good times.
Good times. Good memory.
No, not good memories. No. Not a big fan of Grid. I'm not a big fan of dirt. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I don't know, I just felt like the AI in Grid was out to kill me.
I don't like Grid no
AI
more.
AI in Grid is stupid. I mean, Grid has never had a good UI system, ever. I mean, with drifting through turns being the quickest way to get through it, no.
Yeah, I just hate
it. I played the crap out of Grid 1. But I just... And I bought Autosport to race Bathurst. And it was just like, nope. It didn't want to download. So that was $44 gone. And then I bought Project Cars for the PC. And it doesn't play on my PC because it's a Windows 8 PC running Windows 10.
Yep. Service you bad. Upgraded because they begged you to upgrade to 10.
Yeah, and I finally said, fine, I'll update the 10 to shut you all up.
Yeah, that's not going to work.
Yeah.
My wife had to unfortunately force an upgrade to Windows 10 because it's like, oh, well, we gave you a chance. Now we're going to make you download it and install it.
Mm-hmm. Stupid.
Anyways. Well, we got a couple more minutes left because we started late, so feel free to talk about anything else within those 2 minutes.
I was racking my brain at work today, and where Kevin Harvick has finally said he's staying at Stuart Haas, which means he'll be driving a Ford next year. A lot of people are saying Hendrick Motorsports is going to release Casey Kane because Casey's not been performing the way the Hendrick cars want to. Somebody also said Kenseth will replace Kane. I don't really think that will happen, but if it does, it opens the door for Eric Jones to be in a second furniture car. And for Suarez to be in the 20, or vice versa. I think Gibbs will move Jones up because of raw talent before Suarez, even though Suarez is fully sponsored by Aris. But there's a lot of moving around that's going to go on at the end of this NASCAR season. I think Gibbs needs to get rid of Denny Hamlin, because Denny's not as good as the other three. And then Kenseth isn't as good as Kyle and Carl. Kenseth has never been as good as Carl. And Carl's always had lesser equipment. Kenseth has done better. I think Kenseth was a one-hit wonder with the championship. So I think Kenseth... Well, actually, let's see this. If Kane leaves Hendrick Motorsport... I don't know. I really don't know, to be honest with you. I don't think Kenseth would replace Kane. He can't. Because Kenseth's a big baby. If he don't have the number one, the best equipment, he don't like the race.
Alrighty, you two. I think it's about time we pack up and throw out our dinner, or whatever's left over it, and call it a night.
Okie dokie.
And I finished my entire box of pizza.
Ooh. Eat or done.
Yeah, I'm going to definitely get it done later.
That in college.
Wink, wink.
A whole Little Caesars $5 hot and ready. I've ate a full one of those by myself.
Yeah, it's don't kind know of how I did right now.
Alright, so for myself, KRX, with Windcharger, and special guest Fallen 215, unfortunately we will have to leave the trash for the cleanup crew. But we'll be back in June with, excuse me, one of the two events that we will eventually vote on. So keep your eyes peeled on one of those Mondays for Twitch. And other than that, thank you very much, you two, for participating and talking for most of the time while I got to eat my dinner.
Aight, no problem, man.
This is the part where you can say anything else you want before I play the music.
I'm trying to think, but I can't think anything out of my head about the top of my...
Congratulations, you proved that you don't have anything in your head.
I don't.
Oh my god!
There's nothing in my head.
But you gotta go fast.
I'm
gotta,
a zombie.
You gotta go fast!
I'm a fast zombie.
You gotta go fast, like Sonic.
Shank.
Shank. You gotta go!
Go fish.
I also like how your Skype
and
icon
the,
is
this,
scanning.
Ladies and gentlemen, is what we have resorted to at the end of our podcast.
Oh, if Ben was here, we'd be singing.
Yeah.
All right. Oh, yeah, ben, I might be doing a Sonic here. And Knuckles playthrough of Tails, Sonic 3 and Knuckles on my Twitch channel sometime soon, so...
Shameless plug, http://twitch.tv/fallen215. F-A-L-L, L as in Leo, I as in into, and N as in not.
Yeah, I'm not going to shameless plug mine because I have no idea when I'm going to do the next one.
I actually was able to get 9 views the last time I did it, and someone was actually responding and talking to me.
Wow.
Like, I will well, not talking, like chat. They were responding to chat.
Right on, homie.
I will say this, though. I will definitely be streaming games that I play, and there will be a Destiny story walkthrough with my ex, Sarah. Because she likes playing story, and she don't have anybody else play story with her.
And Destiny has a story?
Yes, believe it or not, Destiny has a story mode.
I like how we have a lot of stuff to talk about, but... Have a good night, guys. I'm gonna play the music. The signals were done.
Bye.
Oh my god, music.
Bye.
Stop stream button. Yeah. The Macho Man, he tells you to hit the stop stream button. Yeah.
No pepper on my macaroni and cheese, thank you.
I don't want your macaroni and cheese.
I don't want your macaroni and cheese.
You sound like you're taking a shit on the toilet.
I'm gonna eat my pizza. My pepperoni on it. It's banging. Get them little Caesars. Yeah, $5.